It's Christy here. Let me show you how you can set up a style of captions in Descript and how to save these so you can use them later. Unfortunately, Descript doesn't allow you to save presets of different properties and objects, except if you save them as part of a layout pack or a layout. It used to be called templates, but now it's called layout packs. It's pretty much the same thing. So if you have a caption customization that you would like to save and use again later without changing all the options, this is the video for you. Let me show you how it works. So I've got a blank project in here, and I'm going to add a caption style on the screen. You don't have to have existing content, but just so you know, when you apply this layout, this template, if you want, that we are saving, it may overwrite some of the things in your future projects, but it's not going to delete anything. You can just bring them back. And let me show you. So I'm going to go to the captions on the right-hand side, and I can just pick up whatever style I want from here. It doesn't matter because I can customize anything I want. So I'm just going to choose this basic one with the little highlight yellow text, right? So click on this. It will add it to this scene in here. It's actually a good idea to do this on a blank scene. The problem with doing it this way, if it's a blank scene or I have no content, I will not be able to see the text because there is no speech, right? So it's, you know, if you want to customize this, you better do it on a piece of content you already have. And usually this is what I do. I create an element or a template or anything I want to save for later on an actual piece of content that I'm editing. So let me switch to a project where I can see the text. So here we go. I am inside of a video that I edited for my friend Chris Menard, and I'm going to add the captions in here. So I'm going to click to add this same one down here. And by default, Descript just adds it with the style that it was saved in there, right? So I can customize this, and I want to just change something. I want to make it a single line. So just resize this box to be a single line like this. And I would like the highlight to be, let's say, some kind of purple, right? So I'm just going to click the color here and change to a different color. Maybe this dark blue or purple, whatever this is. Okay, here we go. It's not very visible. It doesn't matter. So you can make any other changes you would like. If you click on the custom here, you can change all the options that you want, whatever fill, which is the basic color of this. Let's make this yellow. You know, that's the future text. That's the previous text. The highlighted text is purple. You can change all of the other options in here. Maybe add a border to it, like 2 pixels. That's not very visible. I'm just going to make it thicker and make the color white on the border. Okay, this looks a bit ridiculous, but just to illustrate that I'm actually able to customize everything and save it like this, right? So if I now close this and play this.
You can now reference your organization.
It's working fine. I like the style. How do I save this now for the future, right? So what I do is I save this scene itself, the scene where this caption is in. So you want to maybe not save the video. If you don't want that, it's fine. We can actually customize that. But look, if I select the video and remove it, you know, look, I've got the captions here. The audio is still there, which makes me able to see the text. So I'm ready to now save this. So the way to save it, and I'm using the new timeline at the bottom here, as you can see, there's a number of ways to do this. You can click above here where the scene is. If you right click on this, there is an option save scene as new layout. As you know, in the new Descript, the scenes have been removed now from the sidebar on the left where they used to be to the bottom across the timeline. And any option that you were able to right click on those thumbnails, you can now right click on these thumbnails at the bottom here on this video strip. So I can do this, save scene as new layout, or you can right click on the little thumbnails that show up in the transcript there, right? So that's the first scene. This is the scene I'm in right now. I can right click on this and select save scene as new layout. If you don't have these options anywhere, or you don't find them comfortable, you can always go to the scene panel on the right hand side. And here in the three dots, you can say save scene as new layout. This is the current scene I'm in, and that's what this refers to. So I'm just going to click this. And now look, it's showing me a kind of a preview. Remember, I turned the video off. You don't have to turn the video off. And I can give this one a name. So I'm just going to call it Chris Captions. Okay, that's the name for this, Chris Captions with the purple thing. It shows you a preview. And I can select what type. It doesn't matter. You don't have to select this. But if I want to, I could select captions. This allows Descript to kind of group these layouts in the same place together with a tag or a type if you are creating multiple types and different variations of this, right? So now the question is, which layout pack do you want to add this to? So a layout pack is the previous templates project, okay? Now they renamed it. It's called layout pack, but it's really a templates project. So you cannot save a preset or layout in a, you know, non-existing project. So you have to create a template or a layout pack. So I'm going to click here, select, and it shows me the existing layout packs that I have in my database or my account. I don't want to use these. I want to create a new layout pack at the very bottom. Click this option and give it a name. I'm just going to call it Caption Styles. There you go. And you have a choice to make this pack private, or you want to share it with the drive, which means all of the members of your Descript drive or workspace will have access to this template. If you're working with some assistants or other people who work with you on the same account and drive, they will be able to access this if I choose drive. So I'm just going to choose that and click create. Now I'm ready to save this. Click add and look at this, save layout without script. If I turn this option on, it's not going to save this transcript in here, this audio and video. It's just going to save whatever elements are in here, which is what I'm interested in. It's just this caption style, right? So click add and give it a second. It will now create that layout pack and save this style or scene layout into it. There you go. It has saved it. If I click to open it, it actually opens that project. But what I want to do is now I want to use this in a different project. I want to see if I can now bring the style in without having to customize it again. So I'm going to go out of this project into a different project. Let me do that. So here I am in a different project altogether in Descript, a different project, same client, it's Chris. So let me see if I now can apply that style of caption to this project and have all the styles in. So the way to do that is you open the scene panel in here. I only have one scene in this. I did not split this video into multiple scenes. I just have one scene. I want to apply the caption so they appear for the whole duration. Very easy. Go to scene in here, and in the choose layout, I will open this. And by default, Descript shows me the layouts that they provide by default, their gallery of layouts. I don't need these. I'm going to click change layout pack in here, and I'm going to go to drive. Remember, I saved my layout in the drive space. So in here, I should be able to scroll down somewhere and come across, there it is, at the bottom, caption styles. I can click see layouts if I have more. So in here is Chris Captions, the one I just saved. Now, this thumbnail here, it doesn't look like the one that I saved. The previews take a while to generate. I don't know why, but I'm just going to click on this one here. And there you go. So one thing that you need to be aware of, like I mentioned before, you see the style has been applied, but the video has disappeared. That is fine. That is totally okay, because this layout, like I said, was saved just with the captions and the video was off, right? That's not a problem. I can bring that video back. This is the video in here and it has been deactivated. No problem. If you go to the scene panel again, you will see here the script is now disabled. It is turned off. And it has this little closed eye icon next to it. If I click this icon, there's the video comes back. And now look at this. If I expand my timeline, I should be able to see, look, this is my video stream up there. And this is my captions down here. And if I play them, you see they have the same exact style that I saved. Let's play this.
Information, Microsoft Word, and because of the way it is laid out,
so there you go. I've got the yellow and the white and the purple and the outline exactly like I customized it. So if you want to not have your video turned off all the time when you apply this, you can open this layout pack and modify it and turn the video on. I guess that works. You again, so if I click open in here, I can open that project and edit it. But I'm going to do this in another video because it's already too long. So there you go. That's how you do it. The only way at the moment to save presets of different things is to basically customize them the way you want them, and save them as part of a layout pack. So I hope this helps. And hey, if you want to learn Descript with me, I provide one-on-one coaching calls. Look in the description for a link to book a session or three or five with me, and we can go over any questions you may have. I can teach you Descript from scratch or Riverside or Camtasia. So I hope to see you soon. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.